Today, we're going to be reviewing the GoVflow Pro Bars. Now, as you can clearly see, colors so far look really beautiful, spectacular even. I mean, look at these fireworks. They're just absolutely breathtaking. So that's it, right? That's the whole review. Well, wrong. There's actually more to it than that, and to explain it, the best way I can go into it is just getting to the point with talking about the inaccuracy. So while fireworks and things that are extremely colorful and mostly one singular color pick up incredibly well on the screen, anytime you start adding complex geometry, that's where this product starts to struggle the most. Take, for example, this next example. Look at how it just goes from orange to red, even though the scene barely changed at all. It just feels like more often than not, even though the shades can be good when they're great, you know, like here, you know, it hunts around a little way too much. And that can be very distracting when you're watching over the air televisions or more, again, just dynamically lit scenes that aren't a singular flower on the screen. And even then, it's hunting. Like take this, for example, how it goes from red to pink. Not exactly buttoned up, if I say so myself. Now again, that's just how this product works. You can't expect a whole lot because it's not really that expensive. But even on scenes like this, I would expect the shade of pink to be a lot closer to what's on the screen. It just makes this a lot harder to recommend as a product for somebody looking for a kind of television, ambient light syncing home theater solution, you know? Like, it just doesn't feel like it's fluid enough. Now, people have called this a Philips Hue killer, and I disagree with that statement because at the same token, Philips Hue doesn't have these inconsistencies with their play bars, and that is something to weigh up. Now, we do have to talk about price, because this is cheaper, and if that's all you're after, then great, but from a software perspective, GoVflow has some work to do. Now, there is a benefit with GoVflow, obviously, over Philips Hue, and it's not just the price. Unlike the Philips Hue, which is significantly more expensive, this can read everything that's on your screen and you don't need Wi-Fi for it to work. Like, literally, you can be offline. And you also don't have to be tied to just one HDMI port. Another benefit. So, again, and when I say one HDMI port, I mean like just one HDMI port at a time. Basically, the device for Philips only works with HDMI. If you don't have an HDMI-based device, you're done. And that's kind of annoying for a device so expensive. Where this is a little bit more inaccurate, you are getting the usability and it does have way more features. There's a music mode, there's a scene mode to allow you to just really go in there and customize however you want the kind of light throw that you have out of this thing, which is great. The reason I'm focusing on it for this particular review in this aspect is because I know many people are probably looking at it as an alternative to the GoVflow Immersion, because maybe you have a desktop or a monitor, or maybe a smaller TV you want to try this out on, and I can say that while some colors get right, other colors get very wrong, as you're seeing here. And that's going to be the constant theme. Like, that's not white, that's not purple. I just don't understand the algorithmic decision behind this product. Like, some things can just be way off. And a lot of the reason is because the way they have their ISO set on their camera, they have it set entirely way too high, which blows out everything, which makes red start to look purple. Because of course, when you over brighten something, you're not just changing the overall scenery, you're changing the colors itself. So that's something the camera has a difficult time picking up in. And anyone who's recorded TVs will probably know this, but typically when your ISO is set too high, things are just going to look a mess anyway. And that's basically what happens. You use a camera to try to calibrate the color throw, but because the ISO is set too high, they just end up doing more harm than good. Now, I've sent a message off to GoVflow, and they've said that they've sent that information to their engineering team, but I've yet to see a patch that fixes this or even remotely addresses this problem. At the time of this review, skin tones are still purple, and you still have colors that get wonky and messed up, and it's entirely preventable because it's an ISO-based problem from the software the way the camera's reading. It's just, they need to allow a manual ISO adjustment so that you can set it yourself. So that way, at the very least, you're able to dial in everything the way you really want it to be. Either it's a calibrated mode, guys, or it's not. But all in all, I still think it's a competent product, and it's definitely a fair price for what you're getting. It's really bright, you have tons of features, and while it's not the most accurate thing, it does get accurate from time to time, and you can get some nice colors out of it. It can be distracting, but it is a nice little novel thing to have in your home. And if you really don't have any other options or alternatives, it's okay. Just don't go into it expecting accuracy, because essentially this is about a 3.5 to maybe 4-star product depending on your usage for it. It'd be great for YouTube lighting, for people looking for that. It'd be great for people just looking for dramatic lighting in your room, but for accurate home theater syncing experiences, it's gonna be a little wonky, as you're seeing here.